बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द टॉपिक ऑफ आवर टूडेज डिस्कशन इज रेस्पिरेटरी कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज, मेनिंजोकोकल मेनिंजाइटिस। मेनिंजोकोकल मेनिंजाइटिस इज वर्ल्ड वाइड इन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, अकरिंग स्पोरैडिकली एंड इन स्मॉल आउटब्रेक्स इन मोस्ट पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड। इन द अफ्रीकन मेनिंजाइटिस बेल्ट, विच इज द रीजन इन द सब सहारन अफ्रीका, this endemic situation may alternate with devastating and unpredictable epidemics of meningococcal meningitis. In the African meningitis belt, the WHO definition of meningococcal epidemic is greater than 100 cases per 100,000 population per year. In the other endemic countries, the incidence of greater than 10 cases, 2 to 10 cases, and less than 2 cases per 100,000 population per year, they basically indicate high endemic, moderate endemic, and low endemic countries respectively. An outbreak outside the meningitis belt may be defined as a substantial increase in invasive meningococcal disease in a defined population above that which is expected by time and place. The incidence of meningococcal meningitis varies from region to region and country to country. In Europe, the incidence of disease ranges from 0.2 to 14 cases per 100,000 population, and the majority of the cases they are caused by serogroup B strains. In Americas, the incidence of the disease is less than the European region, that is, the incidence of disease is in the range of 0.3 to 4 cases per 100,000 population. In United States, the majority of the cases, they are caused by serogroups B, C, and Y. In Asia, however, the most of the meningococcal disease cases, they are caused by meningococci belonging to the serogroup A or C. Recently, several severe outbreaks, they affected numerous countries belonging to different regions, especially Americas, Asia, and Europe. Meningococcal meningitis is an acute communicable disease which is caused by Neisseria meningitidis. It usually begins with intense headache, vomiting, and stiff neck, and then progresses to coma within a few hours. The meningitis is part of a septicemic process. The fatality of a typical untreated case is very high, that is about 80%. However, with early diagnosis and treatment, the case fatality rates, they have reduced to less than 10%. Now we will discuss the epidemiological determinants of meningococcal meningitis. First of all, we will discuss the agent factors. Agent: Neisseria meningitidis is a gram negative diplococci. 12 serotypes they have been recognized, which are group A, B, C, H, I, K, L, W135, X, Y, Z, based on the structure of polysaccharide capsule. Majority of the invasive meningococcal infections, they are caused by the organisms of serogroups A, B, C, X, W135, and Y. These meningococci of these serogroups, they have the potential to cause both the endemic disease and also the outbreaks. In the African belt, however, the group A diplococci is the most important cause of disease. Neisseria meningitidis is a delicate organism. It rapidly dies on exposure to heat and cold. Source of infection. This organism is found in the nasopharynx of cases and the carriers. Cases represent only a negligible source of infection. Most often, the infection causes mild or unnoticeable symptoms of nasopharyngitis. Carriers, they are the most important source of infection. The mean duration of temporary carriers is about 10 months. During the epidemics, the carrier rate may go up very high, up to 70 to 80%. The disease is communicable until the meningococci are no longer present in the discharges from the nose and throat. Cases, they rapidly lose their infectiousness within 24 hours of specific treatment. Age and sex. It is a disease of children and young adults of both sexes. However, the highest attack rates occur in infants aged 3 to 12 months. Immunity. All ages, they are susceptible to infection. However, the younger age groups, they are more susceptible than the older age groups as their antibodies are lower. Immunity is acquired by subclinical infection mostly, or clinical disease, or vaccination. Infants derive passive immunity from the mother. The seasonal variation of the meningococcal meningitis disease is well established. Outbreaks of this disease, they occur more frequently in the dry and cold months of the year, that is from December to June. Overcrowding, as occur in various places, especially in schools, barracks, refugee camps, and other camps, is an important predisposing factor. Incidence of the disease is greater in the low socioeconomic group, especially people living under the poor housing conditions with exposure to tobacco smoke, asplenia, HIV infection, and also traveling to endemic areas. Disease spreads mainly by droplet infection. The port of entry is the nasopharynx. The incubation period of the disease is usually 3 to 4 days. However, the incubation period may vary from 2 to 10 days. Now we will discuss the clinical course of meningococcal meningitis. Most infections, they don't cause clinical disease. Many infected persons, they become asymptomatic carriers of the bacteria, and then they act as a reservoir and source of infection for others. In general, the susceptibility to meningococcal disease decreases with age. Meningococcal meningitis has a sudden onset of intense headache, fever, nausea, vomiting, photophobia, stiff neck, and various neurological signs. The disease is fatal within 24 to 48 hours in 5 to 10% of the cases, even with prompt antimicrobial treatment in a good healthcare facility. Among the individuals who survive, unfortunately, up to 15 to 20% they suffer from permanent neurological sequelae. Meningococcal septicemia, in which there is rapid dissemination of bacteria in the bloodstream, is a less common form of meningococcal disease, and it is characterized by circulatory collapse, hemorrhagic skin rash, and high fatality rate. This picture is showing you the different symptoms of meningitis: headache, altered mental status, photophobia, stiffness of the neck, high-grade fever. They are the symptoms of meningitis. Now we will discuss the prevention and control. Treatment with antibiotics can save the lives of 95% of the patients, provided it is started during the first 2 days of illness. Penicillin is the drug of choice. However, in penicillin allergic patients, ceftriaxone and other third generation cephalosporins, they should be substituted. A single dose of long acting chloramphenicol or ceftriaxone is used for the treatment of epidemic meningococcal meningitis in the sub-Saharan Africa. Isolation of cases is of limited usefulness in controlling the epidemics because the carriers, they outnumber the cases. Prevention and control of carriers. Treatment with penicillin does not eradicate the carrier state, so more powerful antibiotics should be used. And for this purpose, rifampicin is used to eradicate the carrier state. Close contacts of the persons with confirmed meningococcal disease, they are at increased risk of developing meningococcal illness. Antibiotics, they are very effective in preventing the additional cases through eradicating carriers. Antibiotics for this purpose include rifampicin, ciprofloxacin, ceftriaxone, or azithromycin. Close contacts include household, child care, and preschool contacts. In the outbreaks involving the limited populations, those with direct prolonged contact with a case of meningococcal disease may also be offered clearance treatment. Mass prophylaxis. Mass prophylaxis of the total population in which some of which may not be infected. It is recommended that a mass chemoprophylaxis be restricted to closed and medically supervised communities. The drug of choice in case of mass prophylaxis are ciprofloxacine, minocycline, spiramycin, and ceftriaxone. Mass treatment provides an immediate drop in the incidence rate of meningitis and also in the proportion of carriers. The efficacy of this preventive measure, of this mass chemoprophylaxis measure, depends to a large extent on the population coverage. There are two types of vaccines available, which include polysaccharide vaccines and polysaccharide protein conjugate vaccines. The conjugate vaccines, they are more immunogenic and also induce immunogenic memory. Both vaccines are available against meningococci of serogroups A, C, W135, and Y. First of all, we will discuss polysaccharide vaccines. Polysaccharide vaccines, they are available in bivalent A and C, trivalent A, C, W135, and quadrivalent A, C, W135, and Y formulations. They are administered as a single dose to persons aged more than 2 years. Most of these vaccines, they are given subcutaneously. Adverse reactions, they are generally mild. The most frequent reaction is pain and redness at the site of injection. Transient fever is also reported in less than 5% of the recipients of this vaccine. Conjugate vaccines. Conjugate vaccines, they are available in different formulations. They can be monovalent, either of A or C formulation, or quadrivalent, A, C, W135, and Y. And combination vaccines are also available based on Haemophilus influenzae type B and Neisseria meningitidis serogroup C vaccine. Conjugate vaccines, they are given as intramuscular injection, preferably in the deltoid muscle or in the anterolateral aspect of thigh in children who are aged less than 12 months. Conjugate vaccines, they are more preferred over the polysaccharide vaccines due to their potential for heart protection and their increased immunogenicity, particularly in children less than 2 years of age. Both of these vaccines, they are safe when used during pregnancy. WHO recommends that countries with high or medium endemic rates of invasive meningococcal disease and countries with frequent epidemics should introduce appropriate large-scale meningococcal vaccination programs. This concludes our today's lecture. Thank you very much.